Greetings. I received another interesting jihad from a Muslim brother named Imran. I believe it is a common missionary Christian trait that they do read stuff that isn't found in the text. Virgin birth prophecy or Jesus being called a Nazarene are just prime example as a precedent, and you just followed the footsteps of Matthew's author. Up to you. The first peculiar claim is against the virgin birth prophecy. That is too foolish to ridicule in this video. The second is a little more interesting, Jesus being called a Nazarene. And in a separate message of the same thread, about Nazarene, it is worldwide accepted now that such a prophecy doesn't exist in any of the books Christians named Old Testament. Ignore the exaggerated claims for a moment. This one was new to me, and I wanted a bone to gnaw on. As always, never ever trust what someone in Islam says the Bible says. First, let's find the mention in Matthew. Matthew 3:23, "And he went and lived in a city called Nazareth, so that what was spoken by the prophets might be fulfilled, that he would be called a Nazarene." I have to admit, it has become a favorite topic of mine, the many prophecies fulfilled by Jesus. I love to bask in God's greatness for having revealed and fulfilled so many details. Yahweh-hu Akbar! My favorite resource is Bible Hub because of the detailed cross-reference support. So I looked up Matthew 2:23 and read through it. Matthew 2:23, "And he went and lived in a city called Nazareth, so that what was spoken by the prophets might be fulfilled, that he would be called a Nazarene." And then I looked to the right, where cross-references always prove interesting. Matthew 21:11, Mark 1:9, Mark 1:24, and another 7 New Testament references. Huh? No reference from the Old Testament. And then I looked back at the verse. I read it again carefully, and it hit me. Let's look at some other fulfillments and cleanse our palates for a moment. Matthew 26:55. "At that time, Jesus said to the crowds, 'Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as you would against a robber? Every day I used to sit in the temple teaching, and you did not seize me.' But all this has taken place to fulfill the scriptures of the prophets. Then all the disciples left him and fled." Matthew 21:42, "Jesus said to them, 'Have you never read in the scriptures, 'The stone the builders rejected has become a cornerstone. This is from the Lord, and it is marvelous in our eyes.' Psalm 118:22, 'The stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone.'" Before moving on, pause the video and take a look at Bible Hub yourself. When you look up Matthew 21:42, you will see 8 cross-references on this topic. Psalm 118:22, Isaiah 28:16, Matthew 21:43, Mark 12:10, Luke 20:17, Acts 4:11, Romans 9:33, 1 Peter 2:7. Look those up. The cornerstone in Zion got 8 mentions. And let's look at another. John 19:28. "After this, knowing that everything had now been accomplished, and to fulfill the scripture, Jesus said, 'I am thirsty.' A vessel of sour wine had been set up there. So having put on a stalk of hyssop, a sponge filled with sour wine, they brought it to the mouth." Psalm 69:21, "They also gave me gall for my food, and for my thirst they gave me vinegar to drink." Let's look at another. John 19:33, "But having come to Jesus, when they saw him already having been dead, they did not break his legs. For these things came to pass to fulfill the scripture, 'Not a bone of him shall be broken.'" Psalm 34:20, "He keeps all his bones, not one of them is broken." And moreover, fulfilling the symbolism of the Passover lamb. Exodus 12:47, it is to be eaten in a single house. You are not to bring forth any of the flesh outside the house, nor are you to break any bone of it. And let's look at another. John 19:34, but one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and blood and water came out immediately. And again, another scripture says, they shall look on him whom they pierced. Zechariah 12:10, I will pour out on the house of David and on the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and of supplication, so that they will look on me whom they have pierced, and they will mourn for him as one mourns for an only son. Revelation 1:7, behold, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. And all the tribes of the earth will mourn because of him. So shall it be. Amen. And let's look at another. John 15:25, but this comes to pass, that the word might be fulfilled that is written in their law, they hated me without a cause. Psalm 109:3, they have also surrounded me with words of hatred and fought against me without cause. And let's look at another. John 19:24, so they said to one another, let us not tear it, but cast lots for it to see whose it shall be. This was to fulfill the scripture which says, they divided my garments among them, and for my clothing they cast lots. So the soldiers did these things. Psalm 22:18, they divided my garments among them, and for my clothing they cast lots. And let's look at another. John 13:18, I do not speak of all of you. I know the ones I have chosen, but it is that the scripture may be fulfilled, he who eats my bread has lifted up his heel against me. Psalm 41:9, even my close friend in whom I trusted, who ate my bread, has lifted up his heel against me. I could add many more. This is part of the proof God exists and the Bible is the Word of God. The word of prophecy fulfilled. 2 Peter 1:19, and we have the more certain prophetic word, to which you do well taking heed, as to a lamp shining in a dark place. You see, the future is a dark, unknowable place for everyone except God. But did you pay attention? Did you notice the word, the concept that is the answer? Let's quickly review. But all this has taken place to fulfill the scriptures of the prophets. What do we easily overlook about scriptures? They are written. Scriptures of the prophets. They are written. And to fulfill the scripture, scripture is written. Fulfilled that is written in their law. Written in their law. But it is that the scripture may be fulfilled. Scripture is written. That which is written must be fulfilled in me. That which is written. Now let's look again at Matthew 2:23. And he went and lived in a city called Nazareth, so that what was spoken by the prophets might be fulfilled, that he would be called a Nazarene. Has it clicked yet? The password is spoken. Words matter, and every one of God's words matters. Look it up in the Greek, and the word is rethen. 2046 in the Strong's Concordance. Speak, mention, tell, say. So what does this mean? To me, it is a very clear indication of an oral tradition spoken by the prophets. That further means, do not look for it written in any scripture. Does it prove error or corruption or incompleteness in the scriptures? Not in any way. There is no missing text. It does not say it can be found in the scriptures. Nor does it say written in the law or scriptures. But it does say one very damning thing about Islam. Islam is desperate to attack the true Word of God by whatever weak, illogical, erroneous, and stupid jihad it can. Christians, if any of you are silly or stupid enough to fall for such garbage, shame on you. Christians, pray for those who buy the lies of Islam. For those who are sincere but blinded by Satan's lies. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.